Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology, and we are here with the September transit video. And many of you had requested me to put the screen for transit, so here it is. So from 1st of September, 10 a.m. German time, this is Sun is at 15 degrees of Leo, Purva Falguni Nakshatra. The Moon will be in Dhanishta, Aquarius. And Mars is about to go retrograde on September. We'll go to the retrogression dates later. Then he's in Aries. He has almost slowed down. He's barely moving even now. Then Mercury is about to cross Leo and enter Virgo, its sign of exaltation. Then Jupiter is in Sagittarius, Purva Ashada. He has reached Purva Ashada again, and Venus has just entered Cancer, and Saturn is also in Capricorn retrograde. Jupiter, Saturn are going to be direct, and Mars is going to be retrograde. So these three major changes are going to happen. So let's go to the dates now. So this is for Jupiter, and this is according to German time again. So Jupiter will be becoming progressive on September 13th, and this long retrogression will end, and so is for Saturn. Saturn will be direct on 29th September, so 13th to 29th. What about Mars? Mars is going to get retrograde on September 10th. Interesting. Until November 14th, he will be retrograde, and on 14 November, he goes progressive. Okay. And then Rahu is also going to change sign. Rahu Ketu, they are going to enter, Rahu will enter Taurus and Ketu is going to enter Scorpio respectively. Okay. So in the month of September, very interesting month it is going to be, quite a lot of changes. So as usual, if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it down below, and if you want a consultation, then please go to my website down below in the description section, exoticastrology.in, and yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. And yes, I have already made the videos for Rahu Ketu's motion to these zodiac signs long back. So if you have not watched it, please watch it. So now, the month is starting by the presence of Sun in Purva Falguni, and then Sun will be in Purva Falguni for another quite some time, actually, for another 10 days almost. And then on around 11th or 12th, it will go to Uttara Falguni. So Falgunis are very beautiful nakshatras when it comes to companionship, friendship and groupism actually. So therefore, whenever Sun transits Purva Falguni, then you will see we get a desire to form groups, social circles, join clubs and all this. So if you plan to join some club or some group, then this is the perfect time. September is the best time always, because Sun is always in Purva Falguni that time, 1st of September, most of the times, of course. So therefore, now when it goes to Uttar Falguni, we will go to 15 September also later. But in Purva Falguni, you get a desire to socialize and meet people, and in Uttar Falguni, you take kind of a commitment. So for example, you plan to join a dance club, then you know, go to 2-3 dance classes and check which one should I go, which one should I join, and then finally you end up joining one of the courses actually. Then Moon will be in Dhanishta, and it starts with this Bhadra Purnima, very famous Purnima this is, and it is said the Purnima is on 2nd, most probably, yes. And it is also said in the scriptures that if somebody donates Srimad Bhagavatam on Bhadra Purnima day, then the person does not take another birth. He or she goes back to the spiritual world. So if you If you have an opportunity and the resources, then you can please donate Srimad Bhagavatam on this day, 2nd of September. It will be very auspicious for you. You can do it on 1st or 2nd, whichever you are comfortable. So the Leo Aquarius axis is very much active. So Leo tells us who we are inside as a person, what are our likes and dislikes, and when it comes to Aquarius, we try to harmonize it with the desires of others. So Leo is the planet or is the sign of independence, and Aquarius is the sign of interdependence. So we are independent in ourselves, and then we become interdependent. We voluntarily place some of our dependencies on others and accept dependencies from others, so that there can be a harmonious relationship between two people. And then Mars is in Ashwini. So Mars has entered Ashwini quite some time back, and currently also he is in Ashwini. So you would have felt that the houses regarding Mars, the houses which Mars rules in your horoscope, depending on your lagna, they have had a new beginning, and certain things have started coming which you did not expect that might have come before. So this is what Mars or any planet transiting Aries does, and now it's going to be retrograde. And I've already made the video on retrograde Mars for this transit, so please watch it if you haven't. Then Mercury is in Uttar Falguni. So because of this, Sun is also in Purva Falguni. So whenever any planet transits Uttara Falguni, we start getting a desire to formalize certain things actually. You know, like for example, Purva Falguni shows meeting of two people for marriage, and then Uttara Falguni shows the marriage itself. So therefore, whichever house Mercury rules in your chart, you will always feel now that there is some kind of a commitment, some legal contract or some force which will try to bind you to certain thing. Okay, that will depend on your dashas. And Mercury is the natural karaka for the 10th house. So anything related to your careers, if you want to do some certifications, or you are planning to apply for some recognition or something like this, it's very good for you actually. Then Jupiter is still retrograde in the beginning, and it's in Purva Shada. And Jupiter is the planet of spirituality, and when it enters Purva Shada, there are certain things which you will realize actually, that you need the help of members of the spiritual community. Without them you cannot do much actually. And then Venus enters 4th charan of Punarvasu, which is beginning degrees of Cancer. And now this is a very interesting placement if you are planning to connect with your spouse at a deeper level, at an emotional level, or even with your children, or even with your mother. So these activities can be good for this month, because Venus will entirely be in Cancer. And then Saturn is still retrograde in the beginning, and he is in Uttara Shada. So Jupiter is in Purva Shada and Saturn is in Uttara Shada. So Purva Shada tells you that there is a need for vision in life, and Uttara Shada tells you how to implement that. So regarding the houses which Saturn rules in your chart, there is something which you will realize that you have to achieve with your hard work. That could be anything. That could be your lagna lord, your 7th lord, your 10th lord, whoever. And then Rahu is hovering around in the last degrees of Mrigashira, and the beginning degrees of Gemini, and he's very soon going to enter Taurus. And Ketu is in Mula, and he is very soon going to enter Jyeshtha Nakshatra. So this month will be a transition month for these planets, and depending on which house Scorpio and which house Taurus falls, you will see there are a lot of things which are coming up newly, which are popping up from the sky actually. And you will also feel that now things are happening a bit differently. So for example, If Rahu enters your ninth house, so in this case, for example, we have Virgo Lagna, so Rahu is going to enter the ninth house, okay, because currently it's 25th August, and by end of September he will enter this his ninth house for Virgo. So then the person might realize that there are certain changes which are happening in the house of religion or father or law, legalities, authorities or something like this, okay. So that's a very important transition month. And then let us go to 15th and check. Ah, this is okay. So this is the chart for 15 September, and Sun is in Uttar Falguni and it is about to enter Virgo after 2 days, and then Moon and Venus are conjunct in the sign of Cancer, so it will be conjunct on 14th and 15th. So wherever Cancer is falling, depending on your Lagna, it's a good time to derive happiness from that house. Whenever Moon and Venus, they are conjoined, then we try to become internal. We try to see that are the things which we want, actually are they making us happy or they are not making us happy, okay. So then we see Mars has entered retrogression, and as I had said in my earlier video, that when Mars enters retrogression, then the houses, so for example here the second lord and seventh lord for a Libra Lagna, so something to do with these two houses, you will really formalize something by November 15, because 15 November Mars will go direct again. Then Mercury enters exaltation, fantastic time. So for example in this case the ninth lord and 12th lord Mercury is in exaltation. So great time to pursue spirituality or anything like this if you are a Libra Lagna person, for example. And then Jupiter goes direct on 13th, and whichever houses Jupiter rules, for example in this case the third lord and the sixth lord, you will see that there are new beginnings happening related to these houses. And then Venus is in Pushya Nakshatra, and Pushya Nakshatra is the nakshatra of Shani Maharaj, but Brihaspati is the deity actually. So it's a great nakshatra for spiritual enlightenment and inquiry and connecting to your gurus, especially Pushya is famous for this. And Saturn is almost slowing down the last 2 weeks, and it is going to now get retrograde. Rahu is almost entered, you see, within 0 degrees. So this is the end of September, and Sun has entered Hasta Nakshatra. And then Mars is fully going retrograde, and after some time he will also enter Pisces. So when Mars enters Pisces again, there could be a sense of confusion regarding what to do. So for example here second lord, seventh lord, and Mercury enters Libra, so by end of September, it's like by 20, so Mercury is in 9 degrees of Libra, so around 25th September almost Mercury would have entered Libra. So by that time you will definitely start feeling that you know, people are wanting to meet more, socialize more and understand each other more, alright. And I guess on the next day maybe there will be this the full moon will be there after 2 days, so maybe on 2nd there is a full moon. The Virgo Pisces axis, that's a very beautiful axis to take care of your health and take more rest and do the things which are necessary. And then except Mars, all planets are direct, and Venus enters Leo and Saturn also goes direct. Alright, so this is a very important month for this year, and a lot of changes and transits are happening, and there you go. And Rahu Ketu, they have changed their signs by end of this month, okay, September. And transits for October will be more interesting in my opinion, because when October starts, Rahu Ketu would have changed their signs and Jupiter Saturn would have gone direct. So more activities you will be seeing in this regard, okay, which we shall discuss later on. Thank you very much for your patience, and if you want a consultation, please go to my website down below. And if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it, and if you want to watch other videos on transits, I will put it up, okay, at the end of this video. Thank you very much. God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him.